Stephen, yep. Ask me what time it is.
What's the time, Chef?
Glad you asked, Stephen.
Voila.
Okay. I think I know where I can go and test this out. I've spent my whole life, my university degree was in technology, my whole career was working in technology, and I obviously love the aviation world as well. So when a new product comes out that takes those two worlds that I love, and I get really excited to try it out, and I get excited to share it with you on the channel. So I'm heading to the airport to test out the new Garmin D2 Air X10 Pilot smartwatch. My first question is, who comes up with these names? First thing to note is this is not the first iteration of the D2 Air. There was a D2 Air, I think it was just called that before it, and now this is the D2 Air X10. I've forgotten which is which. This is the new one. Main difference is you'll notice here on the side, the new one's got this new button in the middle. Now the button on the side is the shortcut button. You can set it to do two things. You can do a single press and a long press. So what I've got is a single press, I've got it set up to show my music, and a long press, I've got it to do a direct to destination. For example, I could do Moorabbin, which is my home airport, get a direct to from where I am now, although it's not going to do it because I'm inside a hangar and there's no GPS signal inside here. Other main difference between the two is the glass that they use. The new D2 Air has got much tougher Gorilla Glass 3 compared to the original, but the beveled edges on the edge here when you're swiping and moving, a tiny bit clumsy on the old one. It's a lot smoother on the new X10. Just on the swiping as well, the hardware has been improved a lot on this compared to the previous version. So you can just see how smooth it is to swipe through everything here. Also the software on it, you used to have to swipe through a single screen for every new bit of information. Now you get these things called gestures. And if you can swipe through, you can see all your gestures in one place. And if there's one that you're interested in, just tap on it. Oh, I've got a phone call here. You can see it just runs a lot faster than the old one screen, swipe, another screen, swipe, another screen, swipe, another screen. But is it just a toy, or can you actually use this watch in the cockpit if you are flying with it as well? So you remember when I said that I really love technology? One of the most infuriating parts of any bits of tech for me is when you have to pair it with something like an iPad or an iPhone. A little bit of a behind the scenes. I've been sitting here for probably about 15-20 minutes trying to pair this to my iPad right now. Now I like to think I'm not stupid when it comes to tech, but either I'm doing something fundamentally wrong or... sorry for the interruption. At this point in the video, you would have noticed I was trying to connect my Garmin watch to my iPad. It uses Bluetooth to connect to whichever device you're using. So if you were already connected to the iPhone, which I was, you can't then connect it to the iPad without disconnecting it from the original device. And I wanted to show you the flight plan integration, how you can get the magenta line display with the course deviation indicator. But I've since taken off all the Bluetooth connectivity from my iPad away, and I've only got the D2 Air X10 connected to my iPhone. It means I can use all the new voice functionality like voice commands, but in the cockpit, even though it's not connected to Garmin Pilot, I can still use all the aviation rich features like the altimeter, the pulse oximeter, different watch faces displaying universal time clocks as well as local time, the direct to airport information, METARs, weather info, all that fun stuff. You don't need to connect to Garmin Pilot to get that aviation rich content on your watch. Even though I do have Garmin Pilot and I do use it, I'm not actually going to connect my watch to it. I'm just going to connect my watch to my iPhone, use all the aviation features in flight, and just use the iPad as an iPad. Don't get me wrong, it's a cool feature, but I don't know when I'd ever need to have my flight plan on my watch when I've got it on. Okay, just thought that was important to cover. Back to the airport. with the old D2 Air, I had the problem with the pulse oximeter, the thing that measures your blood oxygen saturation levels. I kind of went back to using this fingertip clothes peg thing that kind of sits on the end of your finger. I want to get rid of this. So I'm really hoping the new D2 Air X10 has got a more reliable pulse oximeter. And I thought I'd reserve my first test for it here with you on YouTube. So let's see. So the new one's already worked, 95%. The old one, still thinking. Okay, could be something to do with where I've got it placed on my wrist. Let me put the old one. It's stopped. And see, this was the problem with the old D2 Air. It was too unreliable with measuring your blood oxygen saturation. So that's why I never used the watch in flight. But the question is, do I get the same results from the new watch as I do through the fingertip one that I've been using up until now? So let's do it one more time. 96%, 96%. That's the third pulse ox test I've done on this watch. All three have worked first time, which is great because it means I don't need to carry this with me anymore. So let's go through a couple of quick questions after I asked you guys on Instagram what you wanted to know about the D2 Air. A couple of you, Ultra82C_DaVince, asking, does it work with 4Flight? As far as I'm aware at the moment, no, only with Garmin Pilot. Kenzie, Isabella, best for IFR or VFR? I'm actually gonna test this in flight in a future video. I'll have a better idea back then, but honestly, I don't think it's gonna matter IFR or VFR. KS Brendan, is it worth it if you're a renter rather than an owner? Good question. I actually don't think it matters whether you're a renter or owner. What matters is how many hours you're gonna be flying. If you're only flying a few hours and you're new in your training and you wanna be spending money on something, I'd probably suggest spend money on fuel rather than a gadget like this. But if you fly quite a lot and it is gonna complement your flying, then I don't think it matters if you rent or own. It's still gonna be useful. F-Right 61, is it good for fitness tracking too? Yes. Lots of you asking about the oxygen levels. Is it working better than the old one? I hope I answered that, but I genuinely think it is. Bron in NZ, can you genuinely see yourself using it in flight? Yeah, I honestly can. Wouldn't have seen myself using the original D2 Air in flight, but because this one, it just runs a lot quicker. It's a lot more intuitive. I like the user interface. And it seems to work, it like actually works a lot better than the previous version. As a compliment to my flying, yes, I can see myself using this in flight. Shane on travel, what's the battery life? As with everything that Garmin makes, I don't know what magic they weave in their factories, but the battery life on this thing is insane. It's currently showing 35% battery. When I got this out of the box about 6 days ago, I gave it about a 3/4 charge to, I think it was 75%. Still showing 35% after all the testing, running, playing about with the phone. Dan Bellis, will it do golf, running and cycling stuff too? Yeah, you've got all your standard activities on here that you'd expect. Walking, indoor walking, outdoor trails, floor climbing. You get the idea. There's a lot on there. PT Long 01, does it have AU taps? Yes, it does. Just go into your airport here. You can scroll down, find the weather. And then if you swipe through the weather, there you go. There's the tap. Wind variable 3 knots. You wouldn't think that with the noise that the hangar doors are making at the moment. Dom Inman, what's the weight like? Do you notice it when you're moving your arms around? All jokes aside, it's a very, very light smartwatch. It's not heavy at all. Hi, I am Sia. Does it cost an arm and a leg? Depends how much value you place on an arm and a leg, but it costs between about 800 and 850 Australian dollars online at the moment. Lockie Home 02, does it work just as well in Australia as it would in the US? Well, it's got a worldwide airport database in it, so I don't think it matters whereabouts in the world you are. Full disclosure, Garmin did send me this watch for free, so thank you Garmin, I do appreciate that. But let me know what you want to know about the new D2 Air X10. Thank you as always for watching, see you in the next video.